Hello, welcome to my class. Today I will start a new chapter, control system, which is the most important chapter in electrical engineering. In this class, I will say some basic parts, the definition, types, structure, types of feedback, and what is the transfer function. Let's start about this chapter. First of all, we have to know what is a control system. What is the definition of control system? The system which combines together to perform a specific task is known as control system. It means three or more systems when combines together to do a particular work is known as control system. And the definition says the system which works together to perform a specific task is known as control system. And we know that in every system there is an input as well as an output. If the output is depend upon the input, then it is known as a control system. And after that, we have to go to types of control system. Okay, we know that there are two types of control system. One is the open loop control system, one is closed loop control system. Okay, I have told that one is the input part, one is the output part. Okay, if this is a system part, this is a system, then it has a two parts. One is the input part, one is the output part. This is input and this is output part. In this control system, the input is displayed by R of T, which depend upon the time domain. So it is R of T. Similarly, the output can be explained by C of T. It is also depend upon the time domain. And the system, in this system, there must be a gain, which is denoted by capital G. And the J is equal to C of T divided by R of T. Okay, this is a open loop control system. If you go further, this open loop control system, the next step of the open loop control system is the closed loop control system. It means in the closed loop control system, there is one most extra part will be added, which is a feedback part. Feedback. Then what is this feedback? Feedback means the part of output, the part of the output, it comes towards the input. The part of output, it comes towards the input is known as the feedback part. Now we have to see the structure of control system. As you know that there are the two types of control system. One is the open loop control system and one is the closed loop control system. Now we go for the structure of control system. Here the open loop control system. In the middle there is the gain part. Input side R of T, output side C of T. If only the output is depend upon the input, only the output is depend upon the input part. No input is depend upon output. It means input side has no effect of output. Then it is known as an open loop control system. It is only a linear system. No feedback path is there. So it is open loop control system. Next we go with closed loop control system. Here the input R of T, output C of T, and the gain will be G. The gain is always denoted by G, and the feedback path. There is always a feedback path. From the output side, there is a way which comes towards the input, which is denoted by always capital H. Okay, it means the only one difference is there from the open loop and closed loop control system is that there is the no feedback in the open loop control system, and where in the closed loop control system there is a feedback path which is denoted by H. Okay, now in the next step we have to see that it is a time domain. C of T, R of T, this is the time domain. But in control system, we have to learn about what is the frequency domain control system. It means always the T part is converted with the S part. How we can convert it? We learn in the previous that the Laplace transformation. In the Laplace transformation, always the T domain is converted into S domain. It means we have, if we take the Laplace transformation of R of T, then we can get the T domain is converted into S domain. And the R of T will be converted into R of S. Okay? If you take the Laplace of R of T, we get R of S is there. Similarly, the Laplace transformation of C of T will be C of S. It is converted into C of S, which is the frequency domain and which is the most important factor of the control system. Okay. Here, R of S, C of S. In the closed loop also, it will be R of S and C of S. Okay. Now we have to learn what is the types of feedback. Types of feedback, there are two types of feedback. One is the positive feedback, one is the negative feedback. One is positive feedback, one is the negative feedback. It means if the output in the and it will come only in the closed loop control system. In the open loop control system, there is the no feedback, so there is no positive or negative feedback. What is this positive feedback and what is this negative feedback? In this point, if it is a summing point, if the feedback path is comes towards the input, and if the point is here is positive summer is connected. If this place is positive, then it is known as a positive feedback control system. If this point was the negative, then it is known as a negative feedback control system. In the control system, we know that the negative feedback control system is the most effective than the positive feedback control system. Okay. We know we have learned types of feedback, that is positive and negative, and we will discuss all the things about in the next class or in the further classes. Okay. Then we have to learn what is a transfer function. So, what is a transfer function? Transfer function means, before going towards the transfer function, we have to learn what is the definition of transfer function. The definition of transfer function is that it is the ratio. What is transfer function? In short, we can write it as it is a TF, transfer function. TF is the ratio of the Laplace transformation of output with respect to Laplace transformation of the input. I have written here C of S by R of S. What is the steps to find the transfer function? We have learned what is transfer function. Next, steps to find the transfer function. If in a system, it is a system, the input is given and output is given. Input is R of T, output is C of T, which is given in the posting. So, first thing, find the input and output in the time domain, which is already given in the time domain in the question. This is the R of T, this is the input, C of T is the output, which is given in the question. In the next step, step 2, find the Laplace of the input. The input is C of T, and we have to find the Laplace of input, which is equal to Laplace of input R of S. It is found out. Next, we have to find the Laplace of the output signal. The output is C of T, and its Laplace will be C of S. C R of S is the Laplace transformation of the input signal, and C of S is the Laplace transformation of the output signal. In this, now we have to go for the final step. This is the last step. This is the find the ratio. Means ratio of the C of S with respect to R of S. It is the transfer function. Now the transfer function is defined as the ratio of the Laplace transformation of the output signal with respect to the ratio of the Laplace transformation of the input signal. Okay. Now the class is over. We have already read that what is the definition of control system, types of control system, structure of control system, types of feedback path, and the transfer function.